You guys, I just read the craziest headline of all time and I gotta share it with you. So apparently, Leonardo DiCaprio and this 22-year-old girl, Camila Morrone, are secretly getting married and they're having a baby. Yup. How crazy could this be? After going through a series of blonde supermodels, seems like Leo has finally decided to settle down. So hit the bell and subscription button and stay with me to find out how true this whole thing is. Before talking about the crazy headline I just mentioned, let me review all the blonde supermodels Leo has been with. Maybe we can find out why he chose Camila. Leo's relationship with Kristen Zhang that started in 1996 was one of the most important ones of his life. He was so in love with her that he even took her to the premiere of Romeo and Juliet back in 1997. And if you know Leo, you know he doesn't take his ladies on the red carpets much. He even flew her to the Titanic set for romantic reunions and was very honest about the way he was feeling for her, saying he couldn't wait to see her at the end of the day and that she was the cutest girl in the world. But soon their relationship ended somewhere in 1998. Some say Kristen dumped him for his immaturity, others say he couldn't cope with the relationship in the limelight. Whatever the reason was, Leo moved on to other girls. Like so many other girls, until he found the one. Well, one of the ones. Leonardo's relationship with Gisele Bündchen was the one that lasted the longest out of all his other relationships. And I know it might be hard to see Gisele with anyone other than Tom Brady right now, but long before they got married, Leo dated Gisele for 5 years, and their relationship started in 2000, but they kept things quiet. Every time the media tried to address the relationship, they denied or avoided talking about it. She criticized the media when they suggested that Gisele and Leo were together for marketing reasons. I mean, she had the right to, because thinking about it, he got where he was without her, and she got where she was in her career without him. They didn't really need each other for marketing. In 2002 though, the couple broke up after 2 years of dating. Gisele stated that she had no time for relationships, but Leo didn't want to talk about the past when he was asked in an interview with the New York Times magazine. But soon, the silence ended, and eventually, more time was found, and by the mid-2003s, the couple got back together. This time, it seemed like things were even more serious than ever. There were rumors of marriage and reports that Leo had purchased a custom-made Neil Lane diamond ring. They made it into People's Most Beautiful Couples list, and they even attended the Oscars together in 2005, but they called things off that same year. There were rumors here and there about a possible reason for their split, but no one knew what the real answer was. Until Gisele decided to give an honest interview to Porter. In that same interview, Bündchen talked about struggling with panic attacks and living out of a suitcase, and also living off mocha frappuccinos, cigarettes, and wine. Well, then she decided she no longer wanted to numb herself with smoking, drinking, and too much work. She was becoming more and more aware of things that she had chosen not to look at, and one of those was her relationship with Leo. So soon, she released that she was the only person in that relationship that wanted to do some serious soul searching, so that ended their relationship in 2005. Fortunately, soon after, both of them moved on and found new partners. The relationship that DiCaprio had with Bar Raffaelli started that same year he broke up with Gisele. The two met at the Sports Illustrated party in Las Vegas, and they started dating in 2005 when she was 20. Now, this age thing is important because the rumors about Leo dumping his girls as soon as they hit 25 might have started from here. Anyway, back to Bar and Leo. The couple bonded over their conversation and political views. There were rumors that the two decided to take some time off in September of 2008, but soon after they reconciled, Bar landed her Sports Illustrated cover. And people say that Leo had something to do with it, which was related to making Gisele jealous, but we won't go there. As far as we know, there was no trouble in their paradise. So in March of 2009, the rumors of them getting engaged started swirling around, but the sources denied it. But it seemed like their love for the environment and promoting peace was not enough to keep them together, because the couple ended their relationship in 2011 and Leo moved on to another model. While Leo was trying to find his next soulmate, he had some flings here and there, and the Russian Sports Illustrated and Victoria's Secret model Anne Vialitsina was the perfect one. The couple spent 6 months vacationing together to all sorts of glamorous locations until Leo found a new chick. That new chick was Blake Lively. I know what you all are thinking. She is definitely nowhere close to the blonde supermodel stereotype that is Leo's type, but I guess back then, he didn't know either. He was blinded with food. What am I talking about? Well, apparently Blake was happy to cook and bake for Leo, something he never had in his previous relationship, so it was a safe and cozy place to be in for 5 months in 2011, I guess, right? Probably that is how long his love for food lasted. After his short fling with the before-mentioned actress chef, Leo realized that he'd got to go back to his actual type, blonde models, and this time it was Erin Heatherton, yet another Victoria's Secret model who accompanied Leo for a short while in 2011. The two managed to stick together for 10 months, nearly a year, almost there, but their busy schedule took its toll on their relationship and it all ended in 2012. If you guys feel like this lady is the same one, well, you're wrong. Even though she is blonde, leggy, and a Victoria's Secret model, she's called Toni Garn, not Erin Heatherton. Leo and Toni started dating in 2013, and the tabloids even suggested that they moved in together, but things didn't work out, and they broke up in 2014. Rumors have it that after the split, Leo left a Florida nightclub with 20 girls, but we're not gonna judge him. Here is a safe place. A former prep schooler, D1 golfer, Georgetown University grad, and a Sports Illustrated model was the next potential soulmate of Leonardo DiCaprio, Kelly Rohrbach, and Leo started dating in the spring of 2015, but they broke up at the beginning of 2016. Yep, nothing to see here, not the right blondie, it was just a simple glitch for him. Nina Agdal and Leo became a thing in 2016. She is a Danish model and was Leo's 10th Victoria's Secret model. Considering his previous relationships, Leonardo's romance with Nina Agdal lasted a little bit longer. They vacationed together to the Bahamas and Montauk, but their relationship did not go further than that. But soon after, Leo found the one and only Camila Morrone. And you may not believe this, but they have been together since 2017. Just to give you an idea of how young Camila is, I gotta tell you that she was born the same year the Titanic debuted in theaters. Could this be a sign? Well, let me tell you how this happened, and then you can decide for yourselves. The first time Leo and Camila were spotted together was in December of 2017, when they were seen shopping at Barney's in Los Angeles. In the same month, Leo was spotted leaving Morrone's Los Angeles home, and towards the end of the month, they were seen skiing together in Aspen. Still, no one was sure if this was only a fling or if they were actually together until April of 2018 at Coachella. The couple was captured showing some major PDA, and for Leo, showing public affection is too much. That's the next level for him. According to the reports, by August of 2018, Leo and Cammy's relationship was going pretty well. They were spending a lot of time together, and it seemed like he enjoyed her spunky, low-key personality. Nearly a year after the first time the couple was spotted together, E! Reported that Leonardo DiCaprio and Camila Morrone were getting serious. The article even suggested that they were crazy for one another and had already seen each other's families, but the marriage was not on the horizon. However, in the same month, Us Weekly wrote another piece saying that they were talking about getting engaged. Which one was true? Wait to find out, guys. So, come next April, the couple was again spotted attending Coachella for the second year in a row. And in March of the same year, something happened that I never thought I would see Leo do. DiCaprio was seen taking photos of Morrone at a Hotel du Cap Eden Rock in Antibes, France, being a total Instagram boyfriend. Both were there for the Cannes Festival, but Camila attended the premiere of Mickey and the Bear, and Leo went solo for his Once Upon a Time in Hollywood premiere on the red carpet. This is around the time that Camila shared a photo of Lauren Bacall and Humphrey Bogart on Instagram with the caption, "A love like this," that received a lot of backlashes. Side note, Lauren Bacall and Humphrey Bogart had a 25-year-old age gap between them. And of course, after that, her followers left hateful comments under the post, some of them saying that Leo only cared about her body and that he will end their relationship as soon as she turns 25. Remember that 25 myth we talked about earlier? This is that. Camila took to her Instagram stories to address all the mean comments, saying that people should relax and learn to live a little with less hatred. Also, later, she told the Los Angeles Times this: "There are so many relationships in Hollywood, and in the history of the world where people have large age gaps, I think anyone should be able to date who they want to date." Now, why am I saying all of this? Because people think Leonardo DiCaprio and Camila Morrone are secretly getting married and having a baby. You see how quickly things escalated? Okay, let me explain. According to one and only OK magazine, the reason the actor finally brought his girlfriend to an awards show is because they've tied the knot. The source claims that the couple of 2 years exchanged vows on a private island in the Bahamas shortly before the Oscars, and that they've been trying to keep the news quiet, but decided it was finally time to let some of Leo's showbiz pals and his Once Upon a Time in Hollywood co-stars in on the secret. They told everyone after one of these after parties, and of course, there were lots of hugs, cheers, and tears of joy. Oh yeah, I almost forgot, there's this buzz that Camila's pregnant. Not sure how they got to this conclusion, but the rumors say that Camila and Leo both want to be parents and have been hinting that they're trying. Now, if you've seen Al Pacino's stepdaughter Camila, who, let's not forget, is only 22, you know how thin she is. Not fit, just literally thin. I just wonder where she could keep the baby when she's pregnant. I mean, getting married, okay, I might be able to believe that at some point, but babies? Where do people get all of these rumors from? Could the reason for the rumors be the fact that Camila is the only girl who's not blonde but still managed to stay with Leo for more than 4 months? Could this be a sign that Leo is over with his blondies? I don't know, I have no idea. What do you guys think? Do you believe Leonardo DiCaprio has secretly married Camila Morrone and that she's pregnant? Let's talk about that in the comments, and remember to like, share, and become part of our Curious Sips family by subscribing to our channel. Until next time!